Praise be Jesus.
Hvaljen Isus.
I like to thank God for the blessing and the honor to be with all of you here this evening.
Zahvaljujem Bogu na blagoslovu i časti što sam večeras sa svima vama ovdje.
And I like to thank Father for his invitation.
I zahvaljujem velečasnom na pozivu.
I have been asked to reflect upon the rosary, family prayer, fasting, the intercession of Our Lady and Saint Joseph, which are great powers of our faith.
Zamoljen sam govoriti o krunici, obiteljskoj molitvi, postu i zagovoru svetaca, osobito Blažne Djevice Marije i Svetog Josipa, koji su naši najmoćniji sveci.
I'm going to start with a reading from St. Paul to the Ephesians, chapter 6, from 10 through 14.
Počet ću čitanjem iz Pavlove poslanice Efežanima, poglavlje, glava 6, od 10 do 14. Ubuduće, jačajte se u Gospodinu i u silnoj snazi njegovoj. Obucite svu opremu Božju da se mognete oduprijeti lukavstvima đavlovim. Jer nije nam se boriti protiv krvi i mesa, nego protiv vrhovništava, protiv vlasti, protiv upravljača ovoga mračnog svijeta, protiv zlih duhova po nebesima. Zbog toga posegnite za svom opremom Božjom da uzmognete odoljeti u dan zli i održati se kada sve nadvladate. Držite se dakle, opašite bedra istinom, obucite oklop pravednosti. Riječ je Gospodnja.
We are the people of God.
Mi smo Božji narod.
And we have been given, like St. Paul just told us, the weapons to battle our mission.
I kao što nam je Sveti Pavao upravo rekao, dano nam je oružje za borbu.
We could say that we are heavily armed.
Možemo reći da smo teško i jako naoružani.
We are a courageous and powerful army.
Mi smo hrabra i moćna vojska.
But we have to know the weapons we have.
Ali moramo poznavati oružje koje imamo.
And we have to learn to use them.
I moramo naučiti tim se oružjem koristiti.
And then we have to be conscious of what we have been given by God.
A moramo i biti svjesni onoga što nam je Bog dao.
When times are difficult,
kada su vremena teška,
we look for hope and we look for strength.
Tražimo nadu i snagu.
And as Catholics we know that only God has that to give it to us.
I kao katolici znamo da samo Bog to ima i samo nam On to može dati.
So our relationship with our supernatural life,
pa naš odnos s našim nadnaravnim životom
is vital.
Jest od životne važnosti.
We need to have a conscience very open.
Moramo imati vrlo otvorenu savjest
that understands,
koja razumije
that we really do have saints and angels accompanying us.
Da doista imamo svece i anđele koji su s nama.
Even the souls in purgatory.
Čak i duše u čistilištu.
They are all walking with us through this exile.
Svi hode s nama kroz ovo izgnanstvo.
We are not alone.
Nismo sami.
Jesus told Saint Thomas.
Isus je rekao Svetome Tomi.
Blessed is he who believes without seeing.
Blagoslovljen onaj koji vjeruje, koji ne vidi a vjeruje.
So it's true that we are blind to the spiritual world.
Istina je da ne vidimo duhovni svijet.
Because of original sin.
Zbog istočnog grijeha.
But it's also true that God has given us the eyes to see the spiritual world.
Ali je također istina da nam Bog jest dao oči da vidimo duhovni svijet.
And those eyes are our faith.
A te oči su naša vjera.
And the bigger the faith,
i što je vjera veća,
the more powerful our guardian angel.
To je naš anđeo čuvar moćniji.
who is the guiding light of our eyes.
A on je svjetlo koje vodi naše oči.
In the spiritual world.
U duhovnom svijetu.
So God has provided for us powerful weapons.
Bog nam je osigurao moćna oružja.
One of them is the rosary.
Jedno od njih je krunica.
I am sure that most of you have a relationship, a personal relationship with the rosary.
Siguran sam da većina vas ima osobni odnos s krunicom.
The rosary, the more you know it,
što više poznajete krunicu,
the closer you get to that friendship.
To ste joj bliži i prijateljski.
It is a powerful friendship.
To je vrlo moćno prijateljstvo.
Because it is the friendship with the mysteries of Jesus.
Jer je to prijateljstvo sa otajstvima Isusovim.
And when you are so united to the mysteries of Jesus,
i kada ste tako sjedinjeni s Isusovim otajstvima,
the devil trembles.
Đavao drhće.
Because the devil doesn't want us to know Jesus.
Zato što đavao ne želi da mi poznajemo Isusa.
And sometimes he manages to get us to know Jesus plainly through religion.
Kad mu uspijeva da mi poznajemo Isusa samo kao samo po religioznosti.
And he knows that that is not enough.
I on zna da to nije dovoljno.
Because we have to have a personal relationship with Jesus.
Zato što moramo imati osobni odnos s Isusom.
And Jesus has to be that divine person in our life.
Isus mora biti božanska osoba u našemu životu.
For us to profess our faith,
da bismo ispovijedali svoju vjeru,
we need to know,
trebamo znati
that Jesus is our Lord.
Da je Isus naš gospodin.
And we need to give him the lordship of our whole life.
I moramo mu dati gospodstvo cijeloga svoga života.
That's why the rosary is so powerful.
Zato je krunica tako moćna.
Because when we understand the mysteries in the rosary,
jer kada razumijemo tajstva krunice,
we know that what we are doing when we pray,
znamo da ono što činimo dok je molimo
is giving the lordship to God.
Jest davati gospodinu, davati Bogu gospodstvo.
Is acknowledging those mysteries.
To znači priznati ta tajstva.
Making them real in our hearts.
Učiniti da ona budu stvarna u našemu srcu.
That is a torment for the devil.
To je pravo mučenje đavlu.
He doesn't want you to repeat what has defeated him.
On ne želi da vi ponavljate, molite ono što je njega porazilo.
You exorcise all the area where you pray when you pray the rosary.
Kada molite krunicu, onda egzorcizirate cijelo područje oko sebe.
Because demons can't stand it.
Jer demoni krunicu ne mogu podnijeti.
The reason why our lady, the Virgin Mary, recommends us to pray the rosary every day.
Razlog zbog kojega nam Djevica Marija preporuča svakodnevno molenje krunice
is because every day we have a battle for our soul.
Zato što se svakoga dana odvija bitka za našu dušu.
Our time on earth is counted.
Naše vrijeme na zemlji je izbrojeno.
We have an exact number of days in this world.
Imamo točan broj dana na ovome svijetu.
And the devil knows it.
I đavao to zna.
He wants to make sure we waste our days.
I on se želi pobrinuti da mi protratimo svoje dane.
By being attached to the material world.
Tako što ćemo biti navezani na materijalni svijet.
By being busy only with the material world.
Tako što ćemo stalno biti zauzeti, obuzeti materijalnim svijetom.
But when we embrace prayer,
ali kada prihvatimo molitvu,
and we embrace this great gift of the rosary,
i prigrlimo taj veliki dar krunice,
Our Lady teaches us something very special.
Gospa nam, Gospa nas uči nečemu vrlo posebnom.
She shows us that the rosary is like a fence.
Ona nas uči da je krunica kao ograda.
That we build through every prayer of the rosary.
Koju mi gradimo po svakoj molitvi krunice.
So every Hail Mary.
Dakle, tako svaka Zdravo Marija
is a stick of that fence.
Je jedan štap, jedan kolac u toj ogradi.
Every mystery is a column of that fence.
Svako tajstvo je jedan stup u toj ogradi.
And the crucifix is the gate of that fence.
A raspelo je vrata kroz tu ogradu.
But we have to build a fence well built.
Ali moramo tu obranu dobro graditi.
That way you will be inside the fence during that day.
Jer tako ćete tijekom dana biti unutar ograde.
With all your intentions, all your needs and all your protection.
Zajedno sa svim svojim nakanama, svim potrebama i svom zaštitom.
So how do we do that right?
Kako ćemo to napraviti na pravi način?
When you pray the rosary, you have to be aware of everything you are saying.
Kada molite krunicu, morate biti svjesni svega što izgovarate.
Sometimes people become very mechanical.
Nekada ljudi mole vrlo mehanički.
And they don't realize they are losing concentration in the whole Hail Marys.
I ne shvaćaju da su kod molenja Zdravo Marije da gube koncentraciju.
So that stick of the fence is not up.
Pa onda taj kolac u toj ogradi ne stoji uspravno.
For every stick of the fence to be up,
da bi svaki kolac te ograde bio uspravan,
you have to be aware of every Hail Mary.
Morate biti svjesni svake Zdravo Marije.
How could you be aware?
A kako biti svjestan?
You have to place yourself in the mystery.
Morate sebe staviti u to tajstvo.
So a Hail Mary is part of the Annunciation.
Zdravo Mario je dio navještenja.
And is part of the Visitation.
I ona je dio pohođenja.
If you are aware and you know that this is what you're doing and this is where you are,
ako znate i ako ste svjesni što činite i gdje ste,
you are placing a stronger stick on the fence.
Onda ste postavili najjači kolac u ogradu.
Demons do not live in time and space.
Demoni ne žive u vremenu i prostoru.
They live in the eternal present.
Oni žive u vječnoj prisutnosti.
So when you pronounce a Hail Mary,
pa kada molite Zdravo Mariju,
demons that are roaming around,
demoni koji tumaraju u blizini,
if you are pronouncing it conscious of what you are pronouncing,
ako molite svjesni onoga što molite,
demons flee.
Ti demoni bježe.
Because they don't want to be in front of the archangel San Gabriel and the Virgin Mary.
Zato što ne žele biti u blizini arkanđela Gabriela i Djevice Marije.
They don't want to be present in the meeting from womb to womb of Jesus and Saint John the Baptist.
Oni ne žele biti u prisutnosti sastanka kada su se Sveti Ivan Krstitelj i Isus sastali, a bili su oba dva u majčinoj utrobi.
That is way too powerful.
To je doista jako moćno.
So imagine if you pray the whole rosary conscious of what I'm saying.
Dakle, zamislite, ako molite cijelu krunicu svjesni onoga što ja sada govorim,
there will be no demon around you.
Ne bi bilo nikakvih demona u vašoj blizini.
You will chase them all the way.
Sve biste ih rastjerali.
And you will be protected for that day.
I bili biste cijeloga dana zaštićeni.
So it's very important to understand the day and the night.
Dakle, vrlo je važno razumjeti dan, noć.
That marks the clock that is ticking in our life.
Da to označava zapravo sat koji otkucava u našemu životu.
So we have to be aware of every day.
Moramo biti svjesni svakoga dana.
And that's why we have to consecrate every day to God.
I zato se svakoga dana moramo posvećivati Bogu.
So that in the book of life,
kako bi u knjizi života,
when you come before your personal trial in front of Jesus,
kada dođete na osobno suđenje pred Isusa,
every day of your life,
svaki dan vašeg života,
was consecrated to God.
Da znate da svaki dan vašeg života je bio posvećen Bogu.
And if you pray the rosary daily,
a ako svakodnevno molite krunicu,
the first one to be there in front of Jesus when you appear,
prvi koji će biti tamo pred Isusom kad vi dođete,
is our lady.
A prva će biti naša Gospa.
She is the greatest witness of the rosary.
Ona je najveća svjedokinja krunice.
So it is important to know prayer.
Važno je znati kako moliti.
Because just to pray and recite prayers,
jer samo izgovarati molitve
is not enough.
Nije dovoljno.
We could be reciting empty prayers.
Moglo bi nam se dogoditi da izgovaramo prazne molitve.
Or we could be reciting magical prayers.
Ili bismo mogli izgovarati nekakve magijske molitve.
You know, magical prayers are those that you pray with an intention.
Magijske molitve su one koje molite s nakanom.
And if you do not get an answer to that intention,
i ako onda ne dobijete odgovor na tu svoju nakanu,
you are upset and disheartened.
Postajete uznemirani i malodušni.
Those are conditional prayers.
To su uvjetovane molitve, molitve s uvjetom.
Those prayers are not real prayers.
To nisu prave molitve.
Because if we are to understand that prayer is a conversation with God,
jer ako kanimo razumjeti da je molitva razgovor s Bogom,
then we have to know that the only language that God understands with us,
onda moramo znati da je jedini jezik koji Bog od nas razumije,
is the language of unconditional love.
Jest jezik bezuvjetne ljubavi.
We pray to God because we love God.
Molimo se Bogu zato što ljubimo Boga.
We pray to God because we trust in God.
Molimo se Bogu zato što imamo povjerenja u Boga.
And we pray to God because we glorify him.
I molimo mu se zato što ga slavimo, veličamo.
And then after all of that,
i nakon svega toga,
we tell him about our needs.
Kažemo mu i za svoje potrebe.
But our needs were not supposed to be in the front.
Ali naše potrebe ne trebaju biti na prvom mjestu.
They are to be in the back.
Nego otraga na kraju.
Because God knows us.
Zato što Bog nas poznaje.
He knows what is going on in our lives.
On zna što se događa u našem životu.
So it's good that we tell him.
Dobro je reći mu to.
But it's good to know that he knows it.
Ali je dobro i znati da on to sve zna.
So some people think God is deaf.
Neki ljudi misle da je Bog gluh.
They even say, I wonder if God listens to my prayers.
Čak kažu, ma pitam se, sluša li Bog ove moje molitve?
I tell people, as far as I know,
kažem ljudima, koliko je meni poznato,
I haven't heard that God is deaf.
Nisam čuo da je Bog gluh.
So God answers our prayers.
Bog odgovara na naše molitve.
His way.
Na svoj način.
And his way is the perfect way.
A njegov način je savršen način.
So always when we pray,
pa kad god molimo,
we should present to God our case.
Moramo reći Bogu što želimo.
But at the end we should do like Jesus did in Getsemani.
Ali na kraju moramo učiniti onako kako Isus učinio u Getsemanskom vrtu.
But let my will not be done but yours.
Ali neka ne bude moja volja nego tvoja.
Always.
Uvijek.
I ask the Lord for something, but I tell him, but if you have something better for me, let your will be done.
Ja tražim nešto od Boga, ali mu uvijek kažem, ako ti znaš da postoji nešto bolje za mene, neka tako bude. Neka bude tvoja volja.
God always knows better.
Bog uvijek zna najbolje.
So the power of prayer,
snaga molitve,
is our union with God.
Jest naše jedinstvo s Bogom.
Our trust in God.
Naše povjerenje u Boga.
Remember when Jesus sent the apostles and the holy women of Jerusalem to wait in the upper room after he ascended to heaven.
Sjećate se kada Isus poslao apostole i svete žene jeruzalemske da čekaju u gornjoj sobi kada je on sišao before he ascended?
No, after he ascended.
Nakon što je uzišao na nebo.
He told them not to move, not to go anywhere, to stay in that room.
Rekao mi je da se ne miču, da nikamo ne idu, da stoju, da ostanu u toj sobi.
They didn't know how long they were going to be there.
Nisu znali koliko će dugo tamo biti.
They were in obedience.
Bili su u poslušnosti.
And they prayed for 9 days.
I 9 dana su molili.
That's why we call the Holy Spirit novena, the novena of novenas.
Zato devetnicu Duhu Svetome zovemo devetnicu na devetnicama.
Because on the 9th day the Holy Spirit came, Pentecost.
Jer je 9. dana došao Duh Sveti.
So the teaching of that, of that waiting for the grace.
Jer zato učenje toga čekanja na milost
is unconditional prayer.
Jest bezuvjetna molitva.
They didn't know what Jesus was going to do.
Oni nisu znali što će Isus učiniti.
So when they received these tongues of fire,
pa kada su primili plamene jezike,
and all these miracles occurred,
i kada su se sva ta čuda dogodila,
they couldn't even understand what they received.
Nisu mogli ni razumjeti što su primili.
So this should be the way we pray.
Tako i mi trebamo moliti.
We pray in the silence of our heart.
Molimo u tišini svoga srca.
Just loving God.
Samo ljubeći Boga.
And knowing how much God loves us and knows us.
I svjesni koliko nas Bog ljubi i koliko nas poznaje.
So now a great gift we have.
Velik dar koji imamo,
which is another powerful weapon,
i koji je još jedno moćno oružje,
is our personal relationship with the saints.
Jest naš osobni odnos sa svecima.
We know that Mary is queen of all angels and saints and all creatures of God.
Znamo da je Marija kraljica svih anđela i svetih i svih Božjih stvorenja.
So when we start with the family of Nazareth,
pa kada počnemo sa nazaretskom obitelji,
we start from the throne of sainthood.
Počinjemo sa samim početkom svetosti.
Because the Virgin Mary and Saint Joseph,
zato što su Djevica Marija i Sveti Josip,
are the columns of sainthood.
Stupovi svetosti.
That's why Saint Joseph is known as the terror of demons.
Zato je Sveti Josip poznat kao strah demona.
The demons cannot even hear his name.
Demoni ne mogu ni njegovo ime čuti.
This year, that is a jubilar year of Saint Joseph.
Ova godina koja je jubilarna godina Svetog Josipa
is a very, very special year.
Vrlo je posebna godina.
As Catholics we should acknowledge that.
Kao katolici moramo biti toga svjesni.
Because the church has given us a great gift.
Zato što nam je crkva dala velik dar.
And it's the extraordinary company of Saint Joseph for everyday battle of our life during this year.
Nevjerojatno, dala nam je nevjerojatno i divno društvo Svetoga Josipa kroz sve dane ove godine.
So when you wake up,
pa kada se probudite,
remember him.
Sjetite ga se.
Before you go to bed.
Prije nego što legnete u krevet.
Remember him.
Sjetite se Svetog Josipa.
It's his jubilar year.
Ovo je njegova godina, jubilarna godina.
He has a special powers for the church this year.
I on ove godine ima posebnu moć za crkvu.
There is a mysterious way of the church imparting these gifts.
Postoji tajanstven način na koji crkva dijeli te darove.
They all come through the Pope always.
Takvi darovi uvijek dolaze po papi.
The Holy Spirit places in the Pope these great gifts.
Duh Sveti stavlja u srce pape te velike darove.
And if people are aware of a spiritual warfare,
i ako su ljudi svjesni duhovne bitke,
they understand that these gifts are not given to the church just for the material world.
Oni znaju, svjesni su da ti darovi se ne daju crkvi samo radi materijalnog svijeta.
It's not like because it's the jubilar year of Saint Joseph.
Nije, dakle, ovo je jubilarna godina Svetog Josipa.
He's going to get me a new car.
To ne znači da će mi on dati novi auto.
No, it's something much better than that.
Da će nešto puno bolje od toga.
He's gonna help my salvation.
On će mi pomoći u mome spasenju.
And this should be our priority.
I to treba biti naš prioritet.
Think about this.
Razmislite o tome.
If Saint Joseph appears to you right now for one second only.
Kad bi se Sveti Josip sada pojavio pred vama samo jednu sekundu.
What would you ask him to do for you?
Što biste ga zamolili da učini za vas?
Think about that.
Razmislite o tome.
I guarantee you that the way to make heaven happy.
Ja vam jamčim da možemo usrećiti nebo.
Is to say, make me a saint.
Jest tako da kažemo, daj da budem svet.
Take me with you.
Povedi me sa sobom.
What else do we want?
Što drugo opće možete željeti?
Everything else is worthless.
Sve drugo je bezvrijedno.
Everything else is going to come to pass.
Sve drugo će proći.
So we should ask for the best.
Pa onda moramo tražiti ono najbolje.
And the best is our salvation.
A ono najbolje jest naše spasenje.
And when we look for our salvation,
i kada tražimo svoje spasenje,
that means we are looking for everybody's salvation.
To znači da tražimo spasenje svih ljudi.
Because if we realize that salvation is the main thing that should be in my heart.
Jer ako shvatimo i razumijemo da je spasenje ono jedino što treba prebivati u mome srcu,
then when I look the people that God places around me.
Pa onda kada pogledam sve ljude oko sebe,
all I want is salvation for them too.
Samo želim spasenje i za njih.
Because I'm holding the real gift.
Jer zato što držim pravi dar.
And I want to share it with everyone.
I želim ga podijeliti sa svima.
When Jesus was dying on the cross,
kada je Isus umirao na križu,
one of his last words,
jedna od njegovih posljednjih riječi,
I thirst.
Bila je žedan sam.
He wasn't thirsting for water.
Nije on bio žedan vode.
He was thirsting for souls.
Bio je žedan duša.
And this is the thirst that we need.
A takvu žeđ, takva žeđ i nama treba.
I always tell people.
Uvijek kažem ljudima.
A very good spiritual exercise.
Vrlo dobra duhovna vježba.
Look around and see how many people are here gathering right now.
Kažem im, dakle, uvijek jednu dobru duhovnu vježbu. Pogledajte koliko je ljudi oko mene sada.
And there are many people watching on internet and listening to radio.
Ima mnogo ljudi koji gledaju internet i slušaju radio.
So we are many here together.
Dakle, puno nas je sada zajedno.
Are you really concerned about their salvation, everyone?
Je li vam doista, jeste li zaista zabrinuti za njihovo spasenje, svakoga od njih?
Do all these people that are here exist for you in your heart?
Svi ovi ljudi koji su ovdje, postoje li oni doista u tvome srcu?
Because if you are sincere,
jer ako si iskren,
sometimes people are like fish swimming by.
Ponekad ljudi prolaze pokraj tebe kao ribe.
They don't occupy any space in our hearts.
Ne, oni ne zauzmu nimalo mjesta u našemu srcu.
They just flow by.
Samo proteknu.
And we meet with lots of people in the church.
I u crkvi se sastajemo s mnogo ljudi.
Are we sincerely concerned about everyone we meet salvation?
Je li nam doista stalo do spasenja svake osobe koju susretnemo?
When someone hurt you,
kada vas neko povrijedi,
are you so courageous?
Jeste li tako hrabri?
And are you such a good Christian?
Jeste li tako dobar kršćanin?
That you still are concerned for that person's salvation too.
Da vam je i tada stalo do spasenje te osobe.
If you don't pass that test,
ako taj ispit ne prođete,
you should work very hard before it's too late.
Morate se jako, jako truditi prije nego li postane prekasno.
Because purgatory is made,
zato što je čistilište napravljeno
of all the unloving in this life. Of all the unloving in this life.
Od svega onoga, od svega onoga što ne volimo u životu.
Empty spaces of love.
To su od praznih mjesta ljubavi.
So make sure when you walk through the crowds in the street.
Budite sigurni, dakle, pobrinite se kada hodate ulicom kroz mnogo ljudi.
Make sure to acknowledge them in your heart.
Priznajte ih u svome srcu.
Because they belong to you.
Jer oni pripadaju vama.
Everyone here with us at this moment,
svatko ovdje s nama sada u ovom trenutku
belong to me, belong to you.
Pripada meni i pripada svakome od vas.
Everyone here is in the book of life of each one of us.
Svatko ovdje nalazi se u knjizi života svakoga od nas.
So you could be totally ignorant about everyone.
Možeš potpuno ne poznavati sve ove ljude.
Indifferent.
Biti ravnodušan.
Or sort of interested in your close friends that are here.
Ili na neki način samo zainteresiran za prijatelje koji su ovdje.
And the rest practically don't exist.
A ostali zapravo ne postoje.
They are just humans.
Samo eto ljudi.
And they gonna get up later and go.
I oni će na kraju ovoga govora, dakle, ustati i otići.
And that is the end.
I to će biti kraj.
It is not the end if we are Christians.
To nije kraj ako smo kršćani.
You have to make sure that you are here and you are aware of where you are and who you are with.
Morate se potruditi i shvatiti da ste ovdje i s kim ste ovdje.
So when we pray to Saint Joseph and the Virgin Mary,
pa kada se molimo Svetom Josipu i Djevici Mariji,
we should ask them for a great gift.
Moramo ih moliti za veliki dar.
The gift of praying for the conversion of all sinners.
Za dar obraćenja svih griješnika.
The gift for our heart to be able to love people.
Dar od kojega će naše srce biti kadro voljeti sve ljude.
The gift for our heart to be concerned about everybody's salvation.
Dar po kojemu će naše srce biti kojemu će našemu srcu biti stalo do spasenja svake osobe.
And that will be a spiritual growth.
To će biti naš duhovni rast.
Many Catholics go to many retreats.
Mnogi katolici idu na mnoge duhovne vježbe.
And workshops of all kinds.
I na dakle svetkovine svih vrsta.
And pretty rich catechism.
I prilično bogate kateheze.
And many of those teachings,
i mnoga od tih učenja,
will not take them into the heart.
Neće ih dirnuti u srce.
Will not make them better people.
Neće ih poboljšati kao ljude.
They just make them more religious.
Samo će od toga postati još religiozniji.
But they don't make it more Christian.
Ali neće postati veći kršćani.
We have to look for a spiritual growth.
Road.
Growth.
Aha. Moramo tražiti i nastojati duhovno rasti.
We need to grow spiritually.
Moramo rasti duhovno.
How do you know if you are growing spiritually?
Kako ćete znati rastete li duhovno?
When the destiny of your neighbor hurts in your heart.
Kada osjećate u svome srcu bol zbog sudbine svoga bližnjega.
When people's salvation hurt in your heart.
Kada vas u srcu boli radi spasenja ljudi.
If you are religious,
ako ste samo religiozni,
every member of your community should hurt you in your heart. You should thirst for the salvation of each one.
Svaki član vaše zajednice vas treba dirati u srce i morate žeđati za spasenjem svakoga člana.
If you are a lay person,
ako ste laik,
every people you meet in the church,
svaka osoba koju sretnete u crkvi,
should be your concern for their salvation.
Morate biti dakle zabrinuti za njezino spasenje.
That is called a spiritual growth.
To se zove duhovni rast.
There is no spiritual growth if you don't have the love, the unconditional love for neighbor.
Nema duhovnog rasta ako nemate, ne osjećate bezuvjetnu ljubav za svoga bližnjega.
So we have to make sure that we are sincere.
Moramo se potruditi biti iskreni.
Dare to look around. Dare.
Da bismo pogledali oko sebe.
And see all the people that God has placed in your life.
I vidjeli sve ljude koje vam je Bog donio u život.
And ask yourself,
i zapitali se,
do I really love these people?
Ljubim li doista ove ljude?
It could be your own family, your own community, your own people at work, everybody that God places in your life.
To može biti vaša obitelj, vaša zajednica, vaši ljudi na poslu, bilo tko koga vam Bog stavi na put.
That is the only way you could say you are growing spiritually.
I to je jedini način da možete reći da duhovno rastete.
Because spiritual growth is growing in the love of God.
Jer duhovni rast znači rasti u Božjoj ljubavi.
Depending on how much we have loved,
ovisno o tome koliko smo ljubili,
that's how high we will be when we die.
To će odrediti koliko ćemo visoko otići kada umremo.
We as Christians have an spiritual image of the moment of dying.
Mi kao kršćani imamo duhovnu sliku trenutka kada ćemo umrijeti.
And it is a mountain.
To je jedna planina.
The mountain of the Lord.
Božja planina.
And a city on top of the mountain.
I grad na vrhu te planine.
The holy Jerusalem of heaven.
Sveti nebeski Jeruzalem.
Our home.
Naš dom.
That is the Mount of Zion.
To je planina Sion.
Where all Sion. The tribes of the Lord go.
Kamo odlaze sva Božja plemena.
So depending on how much you grew spiritually in the love of God.
Ovisno o tome koliko ste narasli duhovno u Božjoj ljubavi.
When you die,
kada umrete,
that's how high you will appear in that mountain.
Tako ćete visoko dospjeti na toj planini.
Some people make it all the way up.
Neki uspiju doći do vrha.
Some people make it halfway there.
Neki dođu na pola puta.
And there are many levels.
A ima mnogo, mnogo razina, stupnjeva.
I guarantee you that we should aspire to be there when we die. Up there.
Jamčim vam da moramo žuditi doći na sam vrh.
It's common to hear some Catholics say,
običajno čuti neke katolike kada kažu,
oh, I really hope that I make it to purgatory.
O, doista se nadam da ću dospjeti u čistilište.
I say, don't make that mistake.
Ja im kažem, ne pravite tu pogrešku.
You should hope you make it to heaven.
Morate se nadati da ćete dospjeti u nebo.
Don't aspire for purgatory.
Nemojte težiti čistilištu.
If you knew what you were talking about it, you will never repeat it.
Kad biste znali što time govorite, nikada to ne biste ponovno rekli.
And I can guarantee you, I know why I'm saying that.
I mogu vam jamčiti da znam zašto to govorim.
Your guardian angel will be very happy if all you have in your heart is the sincere desire to make it to heaven.
Vaš će anđeo čuvar biti jako sretan ako vi u svom srcu imate samo želju doći u nebo.
Because when one has a sincere desire to make it to that city on top of that mountain.
Jer kada čovjek ima iskrenu želju dospjeti na vrh te planine u onaj grad,
then everything one do,
onda sve što ta osoba čini,
is to make sure everything is done to make it there.
Čini tako da bi si osigurala put u taj grad.
So you will live a holy life.
Pa ćete onda živjeti svetim životom.
So it's very important to focus on heaven.
Vrlo je važno biti usredotočen na nebo.
We need to have that conversation in our hearts.
Moramo imati taj razgovor u svome srcu.
And we need to have that prayer in our heart.
I moramo imati tu molitvu u srcu.
We are told that Saint Joseph is the patron of the good death.
Kažu nam da je Sveti Josip zaštitnik dobre smrti.
And if you pray to Saint Joseph for a good death,
i ako se molite Svetom Josipu za dobru smrt,
he will tell you,
on će vam reći,
live a good life and you have a good death.
Živi, živi dobrim životom i imat ćeš dobru smrt.
And we have to remember that.
I to moramo imati na umu.
Jesus told us, pick your cross and follow me.
Isus nam je rekao, uzmi svoj križ i pođi za mnom.
He didn't say, I will carry your cross.
Nije rekao, ja ću nositi tvoj križ.
So we have to make sure we live a good life.
Dakle, moramo se pobrinuti da živimo dobrim životom.
Meaning being a good Christian.
Što znači biti dobar kršćanin.
And a good Christian is he or she that loves unconditionally.
A dobar kršćanin je osoba koja ljubi bezuvjetno.
When you live giving,
kada živite dajući,
and you die giving,
i kada umrete dajući,
at the end you will receive the biggest gift of God.
Na kraju ćete dobiti najveći Božji dar.
You know how good mothers,
znate kako dobre majke,
they wake up before everyone at home.
One se bude i ustaju prve u kući.
And they are the last ones to go to bed.
A posljednje idu u krevet.
And all day they are moving back and forth.
I stalno rade tamo vamo.
Serving everyone.
Služe svima.
Never complain.
Nikada se ne žale.
Always giving themselves.
Uvijek se daju.
When you go to a funeral,
kada idete na pogreb,
and you look at their faces,
i pogledate lica,
they always have a smile.
Uvijek su nasmiješena.
They die giving.
Oni takvi umiru dajući.
And they never expected anything from anyone.
I nikada ništa ni od koga nisu očekivali.
So they were never expecting anyone to thank them.
Dakle, nikada nisu očekivali da im itko zahvali.
So they probably never knew that some of the children or husband or family were ungrateful.
Pa vjerojatno nisu ni znale da su neka djeca ili suprug bili nezahvalni.
Because they were not after gratefulness.
Jer nije im bilo stalo do zahvalnosti.
They were after serving unconditionally.
Njima je bilo stalo do služenja bezuvjetno.
And this is the love of God.
A to je Božja ljubav, ljubav prema Bogu.
Most of the time when you see people that are divorcing,
većinom kada vidite ljude koji se razvode,
each one of the couple, they have a long list.
Svaki supružnik ili supruga imaju dug popis
of the things he did to me or she did to me.
Onoga što je, na primjer, što mi je on napravio ili što mi je ona napravila,
is always because of selfishness.
To se događa uvijek zbog sebičnosti.
Obviously, there are very serious cases for divorce.
Očito ima vrlo ozbiljnih slučajeva za razvod.
And we know that there are problems with alcoholism, drugs, violence.
I toga smo svjesni, ima problema s alkoholizmom, drogom, nasiljem.
I'm not talking about that.
Ne govorim o tome.
I'm talking about a normal marriage.
Govorim o normalnim brakovima.
And sometimes they break down.
Koji se nekada raspadnu.
And a lot of times it's because of selfishness.
A to se često događa zbog sebičnosti.
Because they are expecting too much from the other.
Jer svako očekuje previše od onog drugog.
So how beautiful it is to have the gift of God.
Dakle, divno je imati Božji dar.
When we live not expecting anything back.
Živjeti, a ništa ne očekivati natrag.
When we give not expecting to be paid back.
Dakle, kada živimo bez očekivanja da će nam biti za to plaćeno.
I could stay here talking about this for a long time.
Mogao bih nastaviti o ovome govoriti još dugo, dugo.
But this is the end.
Ali ovo je kraj.
So, I'm going to close with a reading from the letter of Saint Paul to the Galatians. Chapter 6, from 11 to
dakle,
4.
Završit ću čitanjem iz poslanice Svetog Pavla Galačanima, 6. glava, chapter
6,
from
11 through 14.
Od 11 do 14. Gledajte kolikim vam slovima pišem svojom rukom. Svi koji se hoćete praviti važni tijelom, sile vas na obrezanje, samo da zbog križa Kristova ne bi trpjeli progonstvo. Ta ni sami obrezani ne opslužuju zakona, ali hoće da se vi obrežete da bi se mogli ponositi vašim tijelom. A ja, Bože, sačuvaj da bih se ičim ponosio osim križem gospodina našega Isusa Krista, po kojem je meni svijet raspet i ja svijetu. Riječ je gospodnja.
So I thank God for the blessing to have been with all of you here tonight.
Zahvaljujem Bogu na blagoslovu što sam bio s vama večeras.
And for the gift of Catholicism.
I na daru, i zahvaljujem na daru katoličanstva.
We are the people of God.
Mi jesmo Božji narod.
And we belong to the church of victory.
I mi pripadamo pobjedonosnoj crkvi.
And we are the soldiers of the army of God.
I mi smo vojnici Božje vojske.
And we are responsible for the salvation of all of humanity.
I odgovorni smo za spasenje cijeloga čovječanstva.
Because we are eucharistic instruments of reparation.
Zato što smo mi euharistijska sredstva davanja zadovoljštine.
So may God make us all holy so that we can meet in the city on top of the mountain.
Neka nam Bog svima pod...
Peace, I pray, give us your